Hello, hello, good people. This is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker, coming back at you live once again from the Lone Star State with another edition of the Media Mike Speaks. All right, good people, it is 55 minutes past the hour, and yes, we are the voice of the everyday citizen. All right, good people, I want to bring to you this story one of my subscribers sent me. And before I go live on it, I want to go ahead and do the pre-recording on the Media Mike Speaks, because I will be going live on this on New Justice Media tomorrow night. So, as I stated in my previous video, it seems it's open season on pastors. And the police just seem to can't catch a break. So, this story brings us to the grand old state of Alabama. You know, Roll Tide. So I'm going to give my take on this. Yeah. And some commenters have something to say also. So let's get to this story. A black pastor in Alabama said he was wrongfully arrested and charged with a crime while watering his neighbor's flowers. You know, people still water the plants or the flowers these days. That, you know, they still do it. Nothing wrong with that. Now, Michael Jennings was released by his lawyers last week, clearing the way for legal action against the officers, they said in a news release. In the 20-minute long video obtained by NBC News, Childersburg, Alabama. Officer approaches Jennings while he is standing on the side of a home watering plants. When the officer asks Jennings what he is doing, Jennings responds, watering flowers. That really was a stupid question. And if you see someone watering the plants, or if you see someone washing a car, why would you ask them what they're doing when it's obvious you see what they're doing? Instead of an approach like, hello, sir, can I talk to you for a minute? What are you doing? Okay. Hey, it is the Deep South. So anyway, the officer asks if a car parked in the driveway belongs to Jennings, but Jennings says it is his neighbor's car. The officer asks Jennings if he lives at the home, and Jennings explains that he does not. The officer then tells Jennings that police received a call about a suspicious person at the home. Now, Mr. Jennings responds, who's saying that? And then the officer says, they called about it. I don't know, the officer responds. The pastor states, I'm supposed to be here. I'm Pastor Jennings. I live across the street, Jennings says as he continues to water the flowers. I'm looking out for the house while they're gone, unquote. Now, good people, when the officer asks for identification, this way it gets funny. Jennings declines to provide it, telling the officer that he has not done anything wrong. He also tells the officer that he's former law enforcement. You know, which, hey, that should have extended some degree of courtesy to a certain degree. It should have. But bear in mind now, you know, hey, you're dealing with Caucasian officers. I didn't tell you that. And an African-American, you know, man. So the pastor goes on to say, you want to lock me up? Lock me up. I'm not showing y'all anything. I'm going to continue watering these flowers. I don't care who called y'all. Lock me up and see what happens. He really wants to water those flowers, good people. You know, it's your, I will be showing the video tomorrow night, so look for that. Now, Pastor Jennings is subsequently arrested, ultimately, yes. And I can somewhat understand, number one, Alabama, Deep South. Number two, African-American man, he seems a bit like he looks like he's maybe in his 60s. So you're dealing with a time period he came through. And if he's born and raised in Roll Tide country, then yeah, I'm pretty sure he would have a disdain for the police. I can understand that. Just like being caught up down in old Mississippi or Georgia. So anyway, Yeah, I can see why. I would have yielded a degree of cooperation, but based on where it is, based on the history of race relations in the southern states, things can get a little, get a little funny. But anyway, the ordeal started because Jennings' neighbor, a white woman, called police to report a suspicious person. When she realized that it was Jennings outside the home, she apologized. She said, it's him. I know him. But the bottom line is, what you did not know is that another officer approached the scene. Things still got a little heated between Pastor Jennings and this other officer, and that's when they decided to go ahead and take him in. So, anyway, a municipal judge dismissed the charges. Now, an attorney for Jennings said his client was charged with obstructing government operations. Pastor Jennings' attorney goes on to say, this video makes it clear that these officers decided they were going to arrest Pastor Jennings less than 5 minutes after pulling up, and then tried to rewrite history, claiming he hadn't identified himself when that was the first thing he did. Well, he did acknowledge who he was. Now, his attorney goes on to say, this was not only an unlawful arrest, it's kidnapping. It's irrational, irresponsible, and illegal, unquote. Now, under Alabama law, an officer may stop any person abroad in a public place if they suspect that person has committed, or is about to commit a crime. Well, that may be true, but the word say they may stop any person. It did not discuss any degree of identification, because I do believe Alabama is a no identify state, with the exception of these things, but it doesn't say that. So he's probably going to get a payout, most likely. Could it have been avoided? Yeah. Could both sides cooperated? Most likely, yeah. But okay, I tell you what, I'm not going to give my two cents here on that. I am not on that. I'm going to let some of the commenters give their two cents. Well, I'm going to read what they had to say. Now, one commenter goes on to say, there are codified laws for a reason. The officers should have been knowledgeable enough and sufficiently trained to know citizens are not required to identify themselves except in a public place. The pastor, with his prior law enforcement experience, apparently knew that and knew he had no obligation to present his identification. Childersburg PD needs to up its training. All right. Someone else commented, total violation of this guy's First Amendment rights. Can't arrest him unless you suspect him of having committed a crime, being in the act of committing a crime, or has the intent to commit a crime. Plus, they touched him and his personal property, the phone. But we'll see the video tomorrow. Bad, bad, bad. And he doesn't have to provide proof of who he is unless the above three requirements apply. He's going to win the lawsuit hands down. Another commenter wrote, sorry to say this, but police officers need to be taught to think logically. They seem to be getting them from the bottom of the barrel. Time to review minimum job requirements. Okay. Now, this commenter says, good people, pretty much in every state, a cop can only ask you for ID if you are committing a crime, suspected of committing a crime, and cannot falsely detain you under the premise of needing your identification. Not necessarily. Some states have an ID, it's an ID law that you must identify yourself. It's what it is, or present ID. Some states do have that. But Texas doesn't. They have a failure to identify law, but you don't have to present ID. But you must say who you are. That's how it works. So this whole situation should have ended after he told them, I'm watering flowers for my friend and I live right over there. The cops should have realized the guy wasn't committing a crime, assessed that by having their questions answered, which they were, and then leave the scene. All this was caused by some nosy neighbor, or possibly one with a grudge against the pastor, or just plain racist. That should have minded their own business. And when the cop says, anytime a cop needs to ID you, you ID yourself, it's 100% wrong. Just proof that there are cops who have no clue about the law, which they are absolute, absolutely required to know. They are, but we know how that goes. Countless videos are online of young, inexperienced cops saying, "You've got to provide me ID." And the people who know their rights calling for a superior who then tells the young cops to let the person go as they weren't committing a crime. Unquote. Very good. Now, another commenter wrote, "Everyone knows if this guy was white and told police he was watering his neighbor's plants, and I live across the street, it would have been over in seconds, maybe a minute." They may have a point there. They may have a point. Because, you see, Pastor Jennings and one officer did get into it. And the officer said, take him in. So that's kind of what prompted that, you know. These two porkers are the reason good cops take the heat. The only solution is, one, immediate termination. Two, charged with racially motivated hate crime. Yes, what they did is a crime. Three, stiff jail sentence. Four, did he say $1 million reward to victim, not from taxpayers, but from the department budget, and garnished salaries of these two miscreant for life? That's a good point. I think you need to start hitting officers in the pocketbook. Now, the last commenter wrote, "I'm 65 and Latino. I've had a number of interactions with highway patrol, city police, local small town deputies, and border patrol. When a police officer asks for identification, I provide it. Period. I don't present an attitude or pretend I know the law better than the law enforcement officer. No handcuffs or arrest, and the 20 or so interactions have been smooth as silk." Okay, I hear you. You may have a point there on that one too. You know, he may be the type, he don't want any trouble. Here, bye. Okay, so there you have it. I will go live on it to give more in detail about what went on here, and I can understand. I can. Now, the officers, not all of them, were aggressive. The first one on the scene was real cordial. He was very respectful. Another one came on the scene, and that's when things kind of got left. It could have ended better. But unfortunate, it didn't. So anyway, let me know what you think or not. Until next time, this is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker. Subscribe, share, and like to keep me rocking on the mic. Have a good night. I understand you soon, it won't be long. Keep on, keep running.